Hello, it's Scott Manley here, and this.
And this is Sky.
And this is Sky, and what's this here?
Sphero 2.0, I think.
Oh yeah, okay, so this is, yeah, the guys at Orbotix, they clearly watch my channel, and they sent me one of these last year. I think they obviously like the free publicity, so they sent me another one. Now, if you don't know, the Sphero is basically like a cross between a hamster ball and a drone. There's like a drone inside the middle of this thing, and it's totally sealed, and it charges wirelessly. And of course, you can control it with all, you know, your phones and tablets, it'll work on Android and iPhone. But what they also sent me, one of the things about this is you can't really mod it very much because it's spherical and you can't really attach anything to it. But they have another thing, and Sky's got it. They sent me this as well, right? This is the chariot. It is a gizmo, which is, it's literally a chariot. And you can kind of see it, pull it out. It is like a trailer, that's what it is, instead of chariots, romantic sounding creation. No, it is in fact a trailer that you stick on over the thing and it'll be able to drive around. So the other kind of cool thing is you can put like a phone in here in theory. There we go, yes, and so you could have a camera. Yes, you can use it with Lego. Yeah, we could have like a phone with a little Lego spaceship flying along there. How does that work? Yes. So we can imagine voyaging around the house. Or you can build like a Lego phone holder like I've done, because you know what? That would put your video in portrait mode, and I'm not a fan of portrait mode for video. I like, how does this go in? Gotta force it in there. Gotta be a little brutal with these things sometimes. Let me do that. Get it on there. Okay. So let's try this thing. Okay, we ready to go?
Yep.
Okay, where are we taking it?
Kitchen.
Just drive it through the door. Try not to crash it. Whoa, off it goes. Keep moving. Okay, through the laundry, investigating the laundry, right? Where are all the animals? Have the animals learned to fear Sphero? Is that what it is? Are they all hiding somewhere? Okay, so I kind of got it in mind to build the nearest equivalent I can manage in Kerbal Space Program. I thought I could put a rover inside a sphere, but the collision system is just probably not going to support it. But I thought maybe I can build a hamster ball to put a Kerbal in so that he can explore, perhaps as a replacement for a spacesuit. Thoroughly impractical and no doubt prone to failure, but that's exactly what we like in Kerbal Space Program. So what I'm going to do is take one of these core pieces and then add cubic octagonal struts, angle them upwards and use symmetry, and then if I copy the part and re-add it, you'll see that it'll keep on folding up, and so I can just repeat this and repeat this and repeat this until I have a sphere, and then fill in the gaps to make sure that there is no way to fall out of the sphere once you are inside the sphere. So having finished the actual sphere, I just need to add a crew member who will step outside, and then what I'm going to do is he'll jump out into that seat, and the magic thing about that seat is I just need to right click on and he will teleport through inside the object. Okay, so let's put it down. Oh. Okay, well that didn't work exactly as planned. I thought these things were practically indestructible. Well, I shall enlist the power of the F12 menu, hack gravity, and yeah, let's add no crash damage and unbreakable joints for good measure. Look at it, floating down towards the ground ever so slowly, as if it is light on the air like a feather. Okay, now we're going to bring you... Uh-oh, nope, he's knocking that away. I got to bring you in and get you close enough that I can actually... No, stop kicking it around. This isn't football. You're only supposed to be pushing it around once you're inside it. I think this is part of the problem of using physicsless parts, in that their mass is, for all intents and purposes, practically zero. I think I need somebody to hold it down while I get inside. Okay, third time lucky. It is being held down. It's being held down by the strut, which for some reason doesn't want to go any closer to the ground, despite my various efforts. But that's okay. I'll just put my crew member, the lucky volunteer, right underneath. And now I just need to be able to right-click on this seat. And watch, he shall teleport into the object. There we go. Well, nope. Hold on. Get inside it. Board it. And there we go. We have a Kerbal inside a Kerbal hamster ball. A Kerbal ball. Look at that. And then we ditch it. And he shall fall down to the ground without exploding. The not exploding part is, of course, very important in any endeavor such as this. And now, before we make any other irreversible mistakes, I shall save it. There we go, quick saving. Now, in theory, if we're just going to hack or unhack gravity, we should be able to roll this around. But this seat doesn't have any torque. What I want to do is get him to step out of the seat, and he'll run around inside it. He's supposed to run around inside it, but apparently he's teleporting out of it. Bad Kerbal, I did not tell you you could teleport. Have you been performing quantum entanglement without my permission? Okay, take four. Now I have modified this to be a much purer representation of the hamster ball. It has no seat in it. Yes, because I have never seen a hamster ball with a seat inside it. Because hamsters aren't really one for sitting. It now has a little hole in the top, and that should be big enough to accept the body of a Kerbal. So I just have to very carefully place the Kerbal inside. There we go. Uh-oh. Big enough to take the body of a Kerbal, but too small to take the helmet of a Kerbal. Who would have thought? Let's see if gravity will have anything to say about this. Just gonna, maybe if I jiggle him or oil him up. Oh wait, he's walking. Okay, come on, get yourself in there. Yes, there. Now we have successfully entered the ball. Now we can actually test this. We can try going walkabout with it. There we go. Oh, look, it's actually rolling. Oh my god, this contraption defies the odds and is actually working. Now we can go for an exploration of the space base or something like that. So we can imagine that he's exploring some alien world, and he's now protected from the environment by this, you know, steel quad. Oh, wait a second, I don't want to fall out the hole there. Yes, there, aha. Aha, he successfully avoided the hole. That's good to know that did not work. Okay, let's try going sideways so that we don't actually walk through the hole this time. Ah, brilliant! Brilliant, this actually works like I expected it to. Not quite as fast as that robotic gizmo. I'm not even going to try building this with a rover inside. That was the kind of next step up, but you know what? This has been actually pretty darn painful. Now, believe it or not, this was actually a legitimate proposal for a spacesuit design. This was the SX-1 it was the brainchild of some engineers at Johns Hopkins University. And they probably didn't get it much further than showing it to someone at NASA who probably laughed at them. Now, in a similar theme, but actually developed, was the personal rescue enclosure, which was designed for the space shuttle, for the situation where perhaps you had some emergency on orbit and you had to transfer crew from one space shuttle to another. Well, not everyone had spacesuits, so they had this idea of essentially a little inflatable sphere, less than 3 feet across. You would, it would be like a bag that you put the astronaut inside, and they would sit there, kind of all curled up with a little, we've lost it. Oh, darn. Oh, and it's still going, apparently, doing a very strange dance. Yeah, so they would you would sit inside this, kind of all curled up. You'd have like 1 hour of oxygen and a tiny, tiny window to see out of, because without that tiny, tiny window, you would freak out, apparently. These were designed for emergencies. They were designed, they were built, they were tested, they actually put people in them, and after 15 minutes, most people would say they'd been in it for like an hour because it was so horrific. They were never flown, thankfully. But this thing is the perpetual motion machine. I don't think this is going to stop. It's not like it's rolling downhill or anything. Look, it's almost running pace. Well, not quite. It's probably walking pace this thing is managing. It's like a giant mechanical tumbleweed rolling through the space center. Well, obviously, this is once some other little corner case of them being physicsless parts. They will continue until they hit water or something, no doubt. I, on the other hand, need to get back to real life. YouTube does not pay the rent. If you're interested in Sphero, you can check the link in my description for this. If not, that's cool. We'll see you in the next video. Until then, I'm Scott Manley. Fly safe.
Lucky's playing with it? I totally missed that.